I have a maker. He formed my heart before even time began. My life was in his hand. He knows my name. He sees each tear that falls and hears me when I call. I have a Father, he calls me his own.
A.C.K. Saint Peter's nearly parished.
To say, no, be a positive to say, sir.
No, it's a tough part.
Thank you.
744. Small b for dog.
Dog.
3 and c for cat. Small c for cat.
We are good.
Two devices connected. Okay, let's do this.
So, no, no, I can.
Are you introducing me or my?
I'll introduce Michael.
Yes, good evening. It is another Wednesday, and you know what time it is. It is time for Q&A with Linda Shuma. But I'm not Linda Shuma, I'm just standing up on her behalf for just today. So, sorry for the little bit of delay, but now we are on, and we just thank God we'll continue this. I have a guest today, and actually I won't introduce her. She's going to introduce herself, so there's no point. I'll just say karibu and welcome. Maybe if you can just introduce yourself, and then we'll take it from there.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Good evening. Good evening, everybody. My name is Mumbi Mnarobi. I work for NHIF as the Communication and Public Education Officer in Southern Region. And A.C.K. Church, Nyali Parish, has been kind enough to invite me to give some enlightenment on what NHIF is all about, what we offer, and we are going to do a bit of a Q&A session.
Yes, yes.
So that any questions you might have might be answered.
Mm-hmm.
So without much further ado, I think I can carry on and
definitely
do a small presentation just to enlighten you on what NHIF is.
Okay, just take it away.
Thank
and
you.
Welcome, and remember, please don't touch that dial. Just stay tuned until the end, and definitely we are all going to benefit from this. I am Mumbi, welcome.
Thank you. So what is NHIF? NHIF is a National Hospital Insurance Fund. As NHIF, we have various packages that we offer, and these are namely outpatient cover, inpatient cover, maternity package, drug and substance abuse package, chronic illness, renal dialysis, radiology services, oncology package, and the surgical package. Now, let's start with outpatient services. What happens when you register for an outpatient service? You pick a specific hospital, and that is a hospital that yourself will be going for. You have a choice of choosing one for yourself, one for your spouse, and one for each and every child. And the reason NHIF has decided to do this is because sometimes families might be separated due to various circumstances such as work or school. So if, for example, you're based in Mombasa like we are, and your spouse happens to be based in Nairobi, and your child happens to be maybe doing university at Maseno, which is in Kisumu. Okay. So you can pick a facility for yourself, you can pick a facility for your spouse who is in Nairobi, and a facility for your child who is in Maseno.
Mm-hmm.
And these are all covered under your card. So once you choose a facility, what happens? NHIF will cover for general consultation by a medical officer, a clinical officer, or nurses on diagnostic and treatment of common ailments. Secondly, NHIF covers for prescribed lab tests, x-ray investigations for primary care level, drugs, drug administration and dispensing, health and wellness education, minor surgical services, and family planning, anti and postnatal services. Now, when it comes to inpatient cover, NHIF has three categories. There's a comprehensive cover, which normally happens under government hospitals. There's non-comprehensive, which happens under private hospitals. There's category A, which is government facilities, category B, which is faith-based facilities, and category C, which takes care of private high-end hospitals. Inpatient covers consultation, hospital accommodation, which is normally referred to as bed services, nursing care facilities, lab or other medically necessary services, physician surgeons or physiotherapist fees, operational theater charges, and prescribed drugs, medications, and dressings. Now, let's move on to the maternity and child delivery package. This covers child normal delivery and cesarean section, and also related reproductive health services like manual vacuum aspiration and family planning services. Now, we get to the Linda Mama program.
Uh-huh.
And it has been brought to my awareness that not a lot of people are familiar with Linda Mama.
That's true.
Now, Linda Mama is a free maternity package provided by the government of Kenya. Now, the government of Kenya decided to offer Linda Mama facilities, and they used NHIF as the vessel to carry this forward.
Okay.
So this is available in all public health facilities. Registration is done at the facility upon confirmation of pregnancy. Now, all Kenyans are eligible, irrespective of whether you are irrespective of your circumstances. As a Kenyan citizen, you are eligible. Linda Mama covers antenatal delivery, both normal and cesarean, and postnatal services, as well as all vaccinations under the KEPI. These are also covered. And let me reiterate that Linda Mama is normally covered in government facilities.
Okay.
Now, the next package we are going to cover is renal dialysis. There's dialysis that is offered a maximum of twice a week. Somebody who is a member of NHIF and they are well covered, they can get renal dialysis twice a week under NHIF cover. There's a kidney transplant, which NHIF pays up to 500,000 shillings for a transplant, and this is only done in an approved NHIF facility. Now, moving on to the drug and substance abuse rehabilitation services. Excuse me. We have members who are entitled to treatment in accredited facilities, and this treatment is eligible for one cover of 60,000 shillings per session. And this is done in a year. Let's move on to oncology package. And this is a big one for NHIF.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Because I think at any level in this day and age, everybody has experienced, be it personally, not necessarily themselves, or sometimes even themselves, or a member of the family or a close friend who has suffered from cancer.
That's true. That's
so, yes.
Yeah.
So NHIF covers chemotherapy.
Okay.
There are different ways that NHIF covers chemotherapy. There's a basic first line, which NHIF refers to as first line. This covers six sessions, and the six sessions are up to 25,000 shillings per session.
Okay.
And then there's a complex chemotherapy package, which is four sessions, and this is up to 150,000 shillings per session.
Okay.
Now, what I want to make very clear is that this is what NHIF offers. So somebody needs to, as much as when somebody has cancer, they're a little bit devastated.
Yeah.
But somebody needs to use a bit of knowledge when they are using NHIF for cancer treatment.
Yes, yes.
Because if if this is the first line treatment, NHIF is going to cover up to 25,000 shillings.
Mm.
So if somebody chooses to go to a hospital that will charge 150,000 shillings for a session first line, NHIF will only cater for 25,000. Then the person will have to top up
the rest.
So it is also very important to do some investigation and see which hospital offers the best services and offers at this rate.
Okay.
Now, second line, that is when somebody is maybe at stage four cancer,
where
they need very serious treatment.
Yeah.
And this is what NHIF caters for, only four sessions at 150,000 shillings per session.
Okay.
Maximum.
Mm-hmm.
So even for this, NHIF advises, please be vigilant. Please look around. And it's understandable that this is a very desperate time.
Yeah.
People are unwell. Uh-huh. Cancer is not a joke.
Mm.
But it is important to look for a hospital that will be able to cater for your treatment so that you do not have to add anything on top of the treatment that NHIF is offering. Now, carrying on with the cancer package, or rather the oncology package,
uh-huh.
we've covered chemotherapy. Now, the other treatment that we offer as NHIF is brachytherapy. This is an advanced form of radiotherapy, and this is covered for two cycles,
mm-hmm.
up to 80,000 shillings. 80,000 shillings.
Okay.
And that is what NHIF covers for brachytherapy. Let's go to radiology services.
Uh-huh.
So this is a basic x-rays, MRI, and CT scans. NHIF will cover two CT scans annually per family.
Per family?
Per family.
Okay.
Yes.
Not per person.
Not per person. Per family.
Okay.
And there are also two MRI scans per family.
Annually per also. Okay.
Annually, mm-hmm. yes.
Noted.
Not per person.
Per person.
Per
okay.
family.
Understood.
Yes. And there is, although this one is not very common, but I can touch on it a little bit. There's a foreign treatment
mm-hmm.
that NHIF has catered for. This is done. This is done on rare occasions. When somebody wants to go abroad for treatment,
uh-huh.
there are certain hospitals that NHIF has contracted in India and we have a deal with.
Yeah.
However, before somebody is eligible for this overseas treatment,
mm-hmm.
they need to get a letter from Ministry of Health, from the Director of Medical Services,
uh-huh.
to be specific,
okay.
stating that this treatment is not possible to be done in Kenya.
Uh-huh.
Once that is established, that this is a specific treatment that is not doable in Kenya,
mm-hmm.
then our customer is entitled to go to any of the facilities that we have a contract with.
In India.
In no. India. India.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
But keeping in mind that this is NHIF will cover up to 500,000 shillings only.
Okay.
Anything on top of that, NHIF is not going
to
be in a position
will have to
cover. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, the patient will have to top up.
Mm-hmm.
Now, why should somebody be a member of NHIF?
Exactly. That would have been my first question.
I think I've gone through what NHIF offers.
Yes, yes.
I just wanted to give a little bit of a brief.
Uh-huh.
And I think now I can open up the floor.
Yes.
For any questions you might have. In case anything that I've spoken about has not been very clear.
Mm.
We can go to the Q&A now.
Oh,
so
actually,
we welcome our audience and we welcome you to bring up any questions that I might be able to answer for you.
Yeah, actually, what I would say, your small presentation has been an eye opener. There are so many things I think either also me and a few people had misconception about. Now, also, especially the oncology package. People would assume, most of the people that talk to, they're like, NHIF will not cater or cover for cancer and all that. But maybe it's because they didn't know there is that amount that is there, anything above. So as you say, we always have to look for facilities or hospitals which are not very exuberant, which we are able to handle. And you opened the oncology package, and I also didn't know about the package on drug abuse, substance and drug abuse, that NHIF also covered. So I think this is a eye opener. So since we can just go to the Q&As and see, maybe because there are a few questions that guys had already also submitted, and I think they are also, you are frequently asked these questions, like the first and common, the basic one will be, what documents do I need as an individual to be a member of NHIF? What are the documents?
Okay, now, when you want to register for NHIF,
yeah.
we need a copy of your ID.
Mm-hmm.
We need a color passport size photo.
Uh-huh.
Because what NHIF issues are photo cards.
Yes.
So you can be a member. You can bring your copy of your ID and fill out the registration form.
Uh-huh.
But without a picture, you will never get a card.
You cannot. I see even most places, even like the banks nowadays, they will do that on site. When you go to the banks is when they'll take the color passport size photos. For NHIF, you don't do that? Or
for
it depends.
NHIF, uh-huh. It is advisable.
Yes.
It is advisable for somebody to just come prepared with a picture.
Okay.
It is advisable for somebody to come with a picture.
Mm-hmm.
Now, when you want to cater for a spouse and children, as the need may be, for children, we need copies of birth certificates.
Mm-hmm.
And if there's any child who is beneath the age of 6 months, 6 months and below, NHIF can accept a birth notification.
Okay.
However, from 6 months and above, we need
a birth certificate.
And then for instances where somebody is taking care of a child who is not their biological child, but perhaps they have adopted the child, they can still be covered under NHIF. But what is necessary is, instead of a birth certificate, an adoption certificate is needed.
Okay.
So that NHIF can ascertain that this is the parent
Or the guardian.
Or the guardian of this child.
Okay.
For spouse,
we
need a copy of their ID, a marriage certificate, and in case people don't have a marriage certificate within their marriage, we'll need an affidavit stating that you live together as husband and wife, and a copy of the ID of the spouse and the spouse's color passport picture.
Okay.
Yes.
And then maybe, you know, we are in an African society where men, most men, I'm not saying it's usually like that, they have more than one spouse. So in such a situation, what happens? Can I have two or more spouses covered under the NHIF?
Now, under NHIF, NHIF will cater for one member and one spouse.
Okay.
However, recognizing that somebody might have more than one spouse, what NHIF will encourage is that since these are the guidelines for registration, you bring a copy of your ID, color passport size picture, and you can choose. If it's your first spouse, you put them under your card. If you have another spouse after that, you open a card for them and pay 500 shillings for your second spouse.
Oh, separately.
So that they can have their cover, they can benefit from all that NHIF has to offer.
Okay.
It's just that they will not be able to benefit from that under your card if you already have a spouse that is declared under your card.
And then just a follow-up question. How many kids and what is the maximum age? Because minimum age you've already given us, it's 6 months. But what is the maximum age and how many kids can I put on my cover if I want to put them in my NHIF cover?
Okay, for children, as long as the children are yours, you have proven they're yours through birth certificate, through adoption certificates, or whatever means that you have used to prove that these children are yours, you can have even up to 20 children.
Okay.
NHIF will not discriminate.
Amen, amen to that.
Yes. Uh-huh. Now, in terms of age, NHIF will cover for your children up to 18 years of age.
Okay.
Because it is believed that once you get an ID, you are a Kenyan citizen, you are
you
grown.
You can sort yourself.
However, if you have a child who is 18 years old, between 18 years old and 21 years old, and they're in school or in college, and you have proof that they're in school or in college, then up to the age of 21, they can be covered for under NHIF.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, and then maybe we'd go to another question, which is how do we choose an outpatient facility? Let's say now I'm in Mombasa County, so how am I able to choose the facility that I would prefer to be treated in?
Okay.
How do we go about it?
Okay, for choice of facility, in the past, and I think this is what we had discussed earlier prior to the meeting, and I think this is what a lot of our customers out there were familiar with. In the past, NHIF used to ask you to come to our offices and choose, fill out a form, and then we do the registration as NHIF.
Yes.
However, in March of this year, NHIF changed the system.
Okay.
So now, you have a registration,
uh-huh.
you have a phone number that you have registered with NHIF.
Okay.
You use that phone
mm-hmm.
and you dial *155#.
*155#.
Yes.
Okay. So does it have to be a phone that is logged on the net or any phone? It can also be just a normal phone, or you have to be online to be able to do the *155#.
*155# can be done even with a mulika mwizi.
With a mulika mwizi, yeah, yes. Okay, that's yes. good. Uh-huh.
The only thing is that this number has to be registered with NHIF under your card.
Okay.
So just *155#,
uh-huh.
and then it will ask you, it will give you a one-time password,
uh-huh.
which will be sent to that same phone.
Mm-hmm.
You input that. It will ask for the county you're in. You input your county, and then it will give you a list of hospitals.
Okay.
From there, you select the hospital that you want to be going to,
mm-hmm.
and that is it.
Oh.
And then you can select for yourself on and for any person that is under your card.
Okay.
Now, for somebody who has a phone that they can be online.
Uh-huh.
With,
yeah.
If somebody has a smartphone or any mm-hmm, other phone that they're yeah. able to be online with, somebody can download the NHIF app,
yeah.
which is found in Google Play Store. That is one option. Once you download it, just tap on choice of facility and follow the prompts,
okay.
and you'll be able to choose a facility.
Yeah.
The third way that mm. you're able to do this is to go to our website, which is www.nhif.or.ke.
Okay.
And then go to health insurance, and then go to NHIF self-care. When you get to NHIF self-care,
uh-huh.
there's a button that you'll push for choice of facility. It is very simple. Follow the prompts and you'll be able to choose for yourself.
Okay.
And this is done so that our customers have confidence
mm-hmm.
that it is personal to them.
Yes.
I have looked, I have seen that this is a facility that will be able to
cater for me and my
and my dependents.
Mm-hmm.
So you have that choice.
Mm.
It is not coming to NHIF, it is you doing it for yourself.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay, and then let's say what happens if maybe I'm relocated, I'm in Mombasa County, then I move maybe to Western or Kakamega. Am I able, using the same USD code or the following the three ways that you say, to change the choice of facility, or am I stuck with the facilities that I'd picked the first time?
Okay, now, if you, for your, let me use you as an example.
Yes.
You live here
mm-hmm.
and you've visited.
Yes.
And let's use Kakamega as an example because uh-huh. that's the one that you use.
Yeah, yeah.
So you've decided to visit Kakamega.
Uh-huh.
And unfortunately, you fall sick, but your hospital is here in
Mombasa.
It's in
Mombasa, yeah.
So what we advise is that if you're in a position to, you can visit the, because we have branches. We have a network of branches countrywide.
Okay.
So you can visit the NHIF branch in Kakamega.
Mm-hmm.
If you're too unwell to visit the branch, you can send a proxy. You can
okay.
send your brother or a friend or a cousin
mm-hmm.
with your card, or if you don't have a card, with your ID.
Uh-huh.
The branch manager will be able to authorize you to use a hospital, and that will be at no cost to you.
Ah, that's amazing.
But you will have to contact an NHIF center
okay.
in order to do that.
And yes. how do we contact the NHIF center?
By visiting the branch.
Oh, by visiting the branch.
Yes.
Whoever you'd have sent there. Also, mm-hmm. somebody has to go there physically.
Yes.
With at least your documentation.
With your documentation.
Either the ID or the NHIF card.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And there's usually one question that people normally also ask. I think it's the same with this. Because sometimes either the card has delayed to come. So I don't have the card, but I'm sick. And I've visited a hospital. Some hospitals are good and some facilities have got issues. Some hospitals, so long as you give them your ID, because I think they are linked, mm-hmm. they'll be able to process either or allow you to be treated. Mm-hmm. But what about those hospitals which don't allow? They say if you don't have the card, you'll have to pay. They'll not okay. approve. What in such a situation, what is a member supposed to do?
When you're registered with NHIF,
okay. uh-huh.
when you're registered with NHIF,
mm-hmm.
Do you remember how we said that you do the registration?
Yes.
You bring a copy of your ID. Is that correct?
Yes.
So as long as you have your ID, if NHIF has not yet been able to issue you with your card, but you have been registered with your ID and your payments are up to date, you should be able to get treatment in any facility using your ID because the systems are integrated.
Okay.
Now, like you had said, there are some hospitals that, to put it your way, a bit naughty or a bit cheeky, that they will not treat you unless you have an NHIF card. This is not supposed to be the case because provided you are a member of NHIF and your payments are up to date and you have your ID number, it is a government document. And you have registered with NHIF using a government document and it is recognized by NHIF.
Yes.
So if this should ever happen to you, we advise you to call, and let me just put this number slowly so that everybody gets
get it.
You can call our toll-free number. It is NHIF toll-free. It is open 24 hours a day. 7 days a week.
Okay.
Each and every day, even on weekends and public holidays. There are always people who are there willing to assist you. This is our toll-free line. It is 0800. 720-601.
Okay.
I repeat again. 0800 720-601.
Okay.
And being a toll-free number, you will not pay.
You'll not be charged anything for the call.
So you can call at 2 a.m., you can call at 10 a.m., there's always somebody who is there to assist you. So in case you have any issue, especially any issue whatsoever, let me just put it this way. Any issue whatsoever, you can call this number. Now, if there's a hospital that you're going to and they're refusing to give you treatment and you have your ID and your payments are up to date and it is at a point that you're not in a position to reach an NHIF officer because NHIF branches open from 8 to 5 on weekdays. You can call the toll-free number that I have just given, and I can repeat the number again because we have officers who are there 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, every day of the year, even on Christmas Day. We have officers who are working. So one last time, the number is 0800 720-601.
That's amazing. I don't know if it is possible with our producer and director, we can take a small break of a minute or so and also sort our background here. This is Mombasa and you know it's windy. Actually, yeah, St. Peter's A.C.K. Nyali, we are next to the beach. It's just a walk away to the beach. That's why you see there's a lot of wind. So we'll just want to take a small break and also see if maybe we have any comments and whatever from our viewers, which you'll be able to tackle them.
Calls me.
Thank you very much, and welcome back to Q&A, yani question and answer. And today we have a lovely guest from NHIF. Nani, trainer, educationist. She'll remind us. And then I'll also want her just to highlight again about the Linda Mama, because actually most people didn't know about this, and it's an interesting, just to highlight the Linda Mama, because I think there was a query. So it doesn't matter whether you are registered or not, so long as you are a Kenyan citizen, you'll be able to use this facility of Linda Mama or something.
Maybe I did make it clear. Uh-huh. Once again, thank you. Thank you for having me here.
Uh-huh.
Again, my name is Mumbi Mnarobi. I'm the Communication and Public Education Officer, NHIF Southern Region.
Mm-hmm.
Now, back to Linda Mama.
Yes. Uh-huh.
Linda Mama is the government of Kenya decided that they're going to help Kenyan mothers
mm-hmm.
to deliver.
Yes.
For free.
Mm-hmm.
So they used NHIF as a vessel,
okay,
to push Linda Mama through.
Mm-hmm.
So since we are using NHIF,
mm-hmm.
if you have an NHIF card,
okay,
you will not be able to register with Linda Mama.
Uh-huh.
But if you are an expectant mother and you have no form of insurance, you don't have NHIF, you can go to any government facility,
okay,
and register with Linda Mama. Alternatively, you can dial *263# on your phone,
okay,
and register with Linda Mama.
Mm-hmm.
And let's be clear that this happens in government facilities. From once you register with Linda Mama, you'll be catered for all the costs of your birth in the government facility. This means prenatal,
mm-hmm.
the delivery itself,
okay.
postnatal,
okay.
as well as immunization.
Ah, okay.
As That's well as immunization.
Immunization. Uh-huh.
Yes.
All so the immunization or just the first
ones
one?
That are covered by KEPI.
Okay.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Ah, that's very
the ones that are covered by KEPI. Mm.
So, in short, Linda Mama is for the expectant mothers who are not yet members of the NHIF.
Of NHIF, that's correct.
Yeah, but so mm-hmm. you can only access these ones through government hospitals.
Government facilities. Yes.
All government facilities, mm-hmm. okay. Mm-hmm. So if you are a registered member and you have some form of insurance, you'll not be able to use the Linda Mama, because at least you can sort yourself out, Cindy.
Let's not say, I don't want to be put on record and saying any form of insurance,
uh-huh.
but not with NHIF.
Not with NHIF.
Because NHIF already offers a maternity package.
Yes, yes, okay.
So you cannot benefit from the maternity package as
then
well
Linda.
As mm. Linda Mama.
Mm-hmm.
Now, for other insurances, I am not familiar mm-hmm. with what their policies are in regards to Linda Mama.
Okay. And you know, on the dependents and all that and the kids, we said the age limit that you can reach up to either 18, or if they're over 18, we have to prove that either they are schooling or something with us. Now, what about me now as the, how do we call, member? Mm-hmm. To up to what age can I use these facilities? Let's say I'm over 60 years. Mm-hmm. Can I still access the NHIF? Can I still be a member and use the facilities and these packages?
Yes, NHIF is open to anybody from the age of 18
mm-hmm.
up to the time they're called home.
Okay.
Whether it is at 50 years, whether it's at 70 years, whether it's at 80 years, mm. whether it's 110 okay. years, NHIF does not have an upward age limit. So any, as long as you're above 18,
mm-hmm.
you can even be 118.
Amen.
And you will still be covered by NHIF.
That is amazing.
And there's one thing that I want to add. I forgot to mention this when we were talking about children.
Uh-huh.
There are some children who are incapacitated.
Yes, yes.
Who are challenged.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Now, if you have a child who is challenged and you have the card saying that this is a challenged child, even if that child is 40 years old and you are up and active and you are an active member of NHIF, that child can be covered under you.
Okay.
The limit is for people who are in a position to cater for themselves.
Mm-hmm.
If you're 18 years old or up to 21 years old, as long as you're in school, from there onwards, it is assumed that you're a citizen who is able to cater for themselves.
Okay.
However, there are some children, some people who are challenged.
Mm-hmm.
It could be a psychological challenge. It could be a physical disability, uh-huh. mental disability, visual disability, in a way that you're not in a position to cater for yourself. You will be covered under your parents as long as they're alive.
Okay.
And as long as you have that card
mm-hmm.
from Kenya Board of Disability.
Yes, yes.
Then you can be covered under your parents.
Okay.
Yes, I just I wanted to make that clear.
That is very good. Okay, and there was also one query. I think I'd ask you a bit earlier about the time. What time does it lapse? Is it the payments if I've paid in advance? Let's say my payments, they've gone until next year. Does it mean, or if, let's say I pay now, but I pay like the 6,000 for all year, does it mean, because like you see for this other insurance, it's yearly. When it reaches December, whatever you've paid and all that, if you've used it or not, Quisha, is it the same with the NHIF? Or let's say we're in September now, then I take a card and I pay for all year the 6,000. Does it mean it will go until September next year, October next year? Or if it's December, Quisha, I have to start afresh again.
Okay, well, when it comes to NHIF, thank you for that question. Now, when it comes to NHIF, we take the year as a
monthly
yeah.
the 12 months.
Okay. So if you pay today is the, is it the 7th of October
mm-hmm.
and you pay for a full year,
yes,
it will be up to next year.
Okay.
Then you'll have to start paying again in October next year.
Okay.
So NHIF caters for whatever time you've paid for.
Mm-hmm.
If you pay for 3 months, it will be for October, November, December.
December, yeah.
Then you'll have to start again.
Again, okay.
But if you put the 3,000, mm-hmm. it will be up to when you've, once 12 years are done
mm-hmm.
from the time of payment.
Okay.
Yes.
There's one question. I don't know if you'll be able to do this because most of the insurance don't cover a dental. What is usually the issue with dental? Does NHIF, my NHIF, will it cover for me for if I have dental issues?
Dental. Now, this one, I know a lot of people will be disappointed, but NHIF, for national scheme, NHIF does not cover dental.
Yeah, okay. Yes, yeah.
NHIF does not cover dental.
Mm-hmm.
The only thing that NHIF can maybe touch on when it comes to dental is tooth extraction.
Okay.
It's tooth extraction, but the dental procedure,
surgery, whatever.
Yes, that.
Oh, but for extraction, the
extraction. Yes.
Okay, that's good.
Yes.
And one thing we forgot to say. Mm-hmm. Now, what would be the mode of payment if I want to be paying my contributions? What mode of payments can I use? Mm-hmm. Can I use M-Pesa, or is it a must I have to go to the offices of NHIF or Huduma offices? How can I go about it the easiest way?
Okay.
Or I can put a standing order in my bank. I mm-hmm. don't know if that one is also legible.
NHIF, the best way to pay for NHIF is through M-Pesa.
Uh-huh.
And the way to pay through M-Pesa, and this is if you're paying for yourself,
mm-hmm.
if you're paying for yourself as an individual, you pay through M-Pesa. M-Pesa, you go to Paybill. Paybill 200. 222.
Okay.
200222.
Mm-hmm.
And then when they ask for the account number, you input your national ID number.
Okay.
Ensure that it's your ID number and not your NHIF number.
Mm-hmm.
So Paybill 200222, input your national ID number, then you put the amount that you pay, we want to pay for.
Mm-hmm.
It could be for 1 month, it could be for 2 months, or it could be for a year.
Yeah, okay.
And then you put your PIN. And that's it. That's your payment is done.
Ah, okay.
And one thing that I have to reiterate,
mm-hmm.
NHIF does not accept cash.
Ah, okay.
We do not accept cash. So do not be told that we are an agent of NHIF, give us the cash, we'll pay for you. NHIF does not accept cash.
Okay.
If you have cash, you take it to National Bank, you take it to Cooperative Bank, you take it to KCB Bank, or you take it to Equity Bank. Once you're at the banking hall, just ask the askari or whoever is in charge that you want to pay for NHIF. There's a special form for NHIF. You fill it out and you deposit your cash at the bank.
Okay.
Alternatively, you use the M-Pesa method the way I've explained it. But never give anybody
cash
purporting to be from NHIF cash, because NHIF has not accepted cash in their offices since 2005.
Okay. That is good to know. Okay, maybe finally, it won't be the final one. Because I've seen and you've talked about there are so many benefits that we get from this NHIF. So let's say I'm not a member of NHIF, but I pay today. After how long will it take so that I'm able to access these services or to be able to get these benefits? Let's say if I pay today and tomorrow I get a sprain and I want to do an X-ray, will the NHIF cover, or how long, what duration does it take before I'm able to reap the benefits?
Okay. Now, NHIF takes 60 days to activate.
Okay.
So if you pay today, you'll be able to use the card 60 days from today.
Okay, that's 2 months.
2 months.
Okay.
And that is if your payments are consistent. And that's why we really encourage people, the minute you register, pay at least for 3 months so that there's the 2 months waiting period, and by the third month when you're eligible, the payment is already in the system. So that you don't have to be stressed out in case unfortunately you fall sick or you have need of the card. You don't have to start running around and thinking, oh my goodness, when did I last pay? So 60 days or 2 months from date of payment.
Okay.
Not from date of registration.
Date of payment.
Date of payment. Okay. Let's be clear on that. Yes.
Okay. And with the M-Pesa thing, is it possible for me to see when was the last time I paid? What is my outstanding balance?
Yes, you can actually check. You can actually check through SMS. Through SMS. You go to an you open up your SMS on phone. Then you dial 21101. In the message section, you put the words ID and then put a space and put your ID number.
Okay.
And then you send to 21101.
Okay.
Once you do that, you send it, and it's at a cost of 10 bob, 10 shillings. Then you'll get all the details. You'll get your card number, the date of last payment. If any payments are due, you'll get to know who your dependents are. You'll get to know which hospital you have picked. You get all the information.
Okay. Okay, maybe this is just one off the cuffs. Let's say maybe before I met somebody, they had their own cover, and then we got married, but she still has her own cover. And then I have my cover, but I want to add her in my cover. Ile yake bado atabaki nayo, or now she'll have to forfeit that one and be under, or she can still also have an independent, or also choose me as a dependent. How does that go?
Okay, now, if you're both employed.
Yes. Yeah.
There's no option apart from somebody to be deducted. If you're employed and she's employed, she has to be deducted and you have to be deducted.
Okay.
But you have the option of putting her as your spouse, and she also has the option of putting you as her spouse. The benefit in this comes where perhaps, and perhaps like NHIF, the cover, if unless they're extenuating circumstances, you're supposed to use the card for not more than 6 months, especially at a go.
Yes. Yeah.
So in case there's any form of emergency, you can use your card. If it's exhausted, then you can use her card.
That's okay.
That is okay.
Okay.
That is okay. Now, when it comes to voluntary payments, you can discuss it as husband and wife and decide that you stop paying and I'll pay, or you stop paying and she'll pay.
Okay.
That is something that can be discussed as a family.
Okay.
When it comes to voluntary, you can have that option of one person not paying anymore. But under employment, because you see, NHIF is an act of parliament.
It's a statutory act.
It's a statutory.
Yes.
So once you are a citizen and you have a pay and you're employed,
you have to be deducted. Yeah, that one I know. Okay.
Yes. So if you're both employed,
mm-hmm.
it has to be that way. Amen. Now you can just put each other as dependents.
Dependents. Mm-hmm. Okay, that's amazing. I think we've had a wonderful and beautiful show, and it has been an eye opener for me also. And I think I'll spread the gospel of NHIF once more, because today actually I've learned a lot of things, and I'll still go back even to your site. Yes, www.nhif.or.ke.
Yes, yes. Okay. www.nhif.or.ke.
Then /health insurance. Also there, where I'll get more details.
The slash health insurance, that's when you're going to the self-help portal.
Oh, but when I just go...
But when you just go to the website, it has a wealth of information.
Okay.
It will give you the benefits. It will give you a lot of information.
I will
now, the one that I'd said slash healthcare slash self-help, that one is specifically for choosing hospitals.
Choosing hospitals. Okay, yes. Okay, I get you. Okay, maybe if you have some closing remarks... I think for me you've covered everything. At a maswali, people are satisfied with your explanations and your presentation. So maybe if you have some closing remarks, and we really thank you, because you've highlighted a lot about NHIF, but I don't know why it's usually not highlighted in your adverts and all that, but you've done a very good job today.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Thank you very much. So I don't really have much to add.
Mm-hmm.
All I can say is that I'm very, very grateful.
Mm-hmm.
We've been working with A.C.K. Church
yes.
since last year,
uh-huh.
trying to sensitize as many people as possible. So it's actually an honor for me to be called here.
Mm.
I'm actually here to represent our regional manager.
Okay.
And he's very happy that this partnership is continuing.
Mm-hmm.
And what I can say, and this is not just coming from me as an employee of NHIF.
Mm-hmm.
This is coming from me as a Kenyan citizen to my fellow Kenyan citizens.
Mm.
NHIF helps.
True.
NHIF saves lives.
Mm-hmm.
So I will urge each and every one of you.
Mm.
There could be a few issues here and there that you're not satisfied with. But overall, NHIF is an excellent, excellent, excellent cover. And it helps and it saves lives. And it saves lives. Yes, that's what I can say. I don't want to get too much into that.
Okay.
I don't want to get too much into that, because if I start talking, I will talk and give testimonials and testimonials and testimonials.
Mm-hmm.
But I encourage each and every one of you to please visit our website.
Uh-huh.
Please engage with any one of our officers.
Mm-hmm.
We have branches countrywide.
Mm.
All of us are open.
Mm-hmm.
All of us are open. We are ready to serve you. We are ready to be here for you. We are ready to help you in each and every way that we possibly can.
Okay.
And then I want to close by saying happy Customer Focus Week
to
all our customers.
Amen. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We are here.
Okay. And as you know, it's been question and answer today. And I hope wherever you are satisfied with the explanation and the presentations. But in case there are some burning issues that you think we had not tackled, just put a comment below and tutamtafuta Mumbi atusaidie. Sasa, this is the good of having connections and network. You know, in Kenya they say it's about who you know and not what you know. Sasa, it's been a good time, and thank you for your time. And you are welcome also to worship with us at A.C.K. St. Peter's Nyali. That's it from me. And just a reminder, and I've just been reminded, I did not say my names and introduce the guests, but I did not even introduce myself, assuming that most of the Q&A guys know me. My names are Joseph Muholi. I'm just standing in for Linda Shuma, our beautiful host, who unfortunately today she was unable to be with us. But thank you for watching, and remember, keep subscribing and keep following us. There are more and more educative things here, or if there is any issue that you want us to tackle, just put a comment up or chini kwa Q&A, and definitely we'll do it. Thank you, and God bless from me and my fellow host, I would say that, Mumbi, Nairobi. Kwaherini.
Thank you, Kwaherini. Okay. God bless you all.